CDFW does helicopter capture work for a variety of species, primarily big game, in order to mark or tag animals and collect information on them across the state. One of the species we do helicopter capture with is mule deer, primarily in areas like the Eastern Sierra, where certain terrain and species are appropriate for that method, as it's relatively efficient. When we do any kind of capture work, one of the primary goals is to put GPS collars on animals. And so that provides us information on the movement and survival of that individual. Those individuals also serve as a mark within the population for mark resites via aerial surveys. That allows us to get a population estimate. We're also able to collect a number of physiological and morphometric measurements. Disease surveillance is another aspect. Now that we've finished the helicopter captures and that we've got marks out on the population, we've got a lot of information about these individuals that we've captured, then that all gets funneled into an integrated population model. And that helps us understand then what's happening to the population, particularly over time. That model can help us inform hunting tag allocations by determining accurate projections based on, you know, individual herd, which then gets combined into the hunt zone and then allows us to recommend an increase, decrease, or no change in the hunting tag allocation. The information, the mapping that we can create based on the GPS collar locations provides us some very fine scale understanding of where a herd is using space. And then in this case, where they are crossing US 395, which is the major highway in that area. They can inform locations to focus on for signage or infrastructure for humans or crossings for animals. And that can help protect both animal and human safety, as well as have an effect on the conservation of the population.